Hey everyone, it's Carolyn Edlund. I'm the founder of Artsy Shark. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm glad you're here today because I have got an amazing topic you will not believe. Please become a subscriber, and if you like this video, give us a like so that more people will find it. I just got to say that this is a topic I have never imagined covering because it is out of this world, literally. I've just learned from my good friend, Graeme Stevenson, and his crack staff over at Color in Your Life in Australia, that they have a huge announcement, and that is that their TV show that profiles artists on studio visits is literally going to the moon, and this is a thing that's happening. So, Graeme, I want to welcome you to the conversation. Graeme is the founder of Color in Your Life, and I want to jump into this conversation about what in the world is going on with the artists that are going to the moon and how you made this happen.
Oh, hi, Caroline. Yes, well, unbeknownst to us, it was only like about 6 or 7 weeks ago, but we have been chosen by a team that's organizing our payload in conjunction with NASA and SpaceX to take all of the TV series that we've put together and take it to the moon and be landed on a probe at the moon, at the south pole of the moon, and for perpetuity. So all of the hundreds of artists that were filmed across the world having the shows go to the moon, which is pretty amazing.
Okay, so let's break this down a little bit. For those of you who don't know about Color in Your Life, they've done how many seasons? Is it 22 seasons now?
22 seasons, yeah.
Okay, 22 seasons of individual documentary half-hour programs that are available online and are shown on TV stations around the world, that where Graeme or one of his staff goes to the artist's studio and does an interview. They show their work in progress, you know, what inspires them, their techniques. You watch the artist create. It's a fascinating program. And with 22 seasons in the can, you have a private, I guess, SpaceX, like Elon Musk, and the rockets that they are developing, which are going to the moon in 2023, are going to be carrying video of TV shows and art and some other things literally to store on the moon in a moon box at the south pole of the moon. Is that correct?
That is correct. We're going up with inside the NASA Viper rover. Now the rover is actually going up to look for water in conjunction, actually building a moon base up there at some stage. If they've got water there, obviously they don't need to take water up. So what they're doing is they're landing us in an area called the Polaris, at the south pole of the moon, and then they will basically place the probe on the moon, and that will be full of art and the TV series that we've put together as well. So basically it's there for perpetuity. You know, thanks to all of the guys that had the foresight to be part and parcel of what we're doing, because what we've been doing for 10 years is pushing this out to as many different stations and networks as we can for the price that we charge, and then basically letting artists have a tool, a great marketing tool for themselves. And unbeknownst to us, now it's going to the moon as well, which is pretty amazing.
So the moon box that's going to be on the moon is going to be like a time capsule of sorts.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so I just want to talk about what was the thinking behind literally putting art, and there's other things too, apparently literature, you know, some of the artistic creation, some of the great work of mankind, of humanity, is going up to the moon for, is this for posterity, for future discovery? What was kind of the thinking behind that?
Yeah, Elon seems to be way, way ahead of his time as it is anyway. Mm-hmm. And, you know, obviously his ambition is to get to Mars and obviously build a colony on Mars as well. But in the proviso, with everything that's going on the planet, I mean, we're sort of racing ahead in leaps and bounds with technology. But things like COVID and, you know, wars with other countries is still part of the mix of who we are, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. And his thought was, well, what if we end up doing the worst case scenario situation to ourselves, and we destroy all of the art and all of the books and literature and film and the episodes of TV that were out there? And basically, he wanted to put something together on the art. It may change as they go along, and they may put something else in the boxes in conjunction with that. But for the time being, it's our TV series that's going up, plus a lot of books and some other artist work as well.
So that's such a, I mean, this is such an amazing and unusual thing to happen. And you, I'm sure you're just honored to have had your series chosen to, mm-hmm. to go in the rocket, to go to the moon. But you've got all of these artists that you've covered, hundreds of artists over the years that you've interviewed that have been part of the series. Their work and their video is going to be stored on the moon. So this sounds to me like an incredible press opportunity and exposure for artists that have been involved with this. What would you say to one of your artists who's now going to be a part of this whole moon trip and having the records on the moon? How are they going to be sharing this? And what are you doing to help just get exposure around the world for this trip?
Well, there's a lot of firsts. I mean, we've filmed in 7 countries, and you know, obviously we have teams and hosts in another 4 different countries now, which is fantastic because they're all out there doing their own thing as well and helping artists to expose themselves to a greater variety of locations as well. But I think as this goes along, lost the train of thought. What were we talking about?
Well, we're just talking about the ways that the artists can use this huge news to how are they going to use this to promote their art and to help get exposure for...
Yeah, this is about firsts. It's about, you know, I said to a lot of the ladies, because 70% of the people that we've filmed have been men, women. And I said, there's a first, it's first time women have been going into outer space mm-hmm. with their documentaries for a start. And it's a first for a particular state. And it's a first for the lady that we just spoke to before, Evelyn Dunphy, mm-hmm. who's in Maine. So she's probably the first artist in Maine to have her work go into outer space as well. So there's a number of firsts that can happen, apart from the fact that there's only 300 artists are actually going mm-hmm. up to the moon out of millions of artists around the world and in perpetuity backwards, another millions and millions of them as well. So it's an amazing situation for them. And I think it's just a story on its own that people will want to know about. I mean, that this doesn't happen every day. This is
this is a historic first. So like you said, are you the first artist from a certain state that's going to have their work on the moon? I would imagine this would be a total bonanza for any artist who's looking for press, send out press releases. I think you said you've got banners that your artists are going to be putting on their websites to tell people that they're part of this important historical moonshot. What about events that you're going to hold maybe in conjunction with the launch of the rocket?
Well, our team here in Australia is planning on putting together a moon ball. So I'm not sure if we're going to have my dancing shoes on by then, but we're planning on screening at one of the theatres and then having a ball that goes with it and everybody comes dressed as aliens or astronauts. But there's a lot of things, and they're putting exhibitions together as well. They're putting mm-hmm. moon exhibitions together so that, you know, we've filmed hundreds of artists in lots of countries. So there's opportunities for all the artists to get together and to do something with this as well. They're literally creating an exhibition around an idea that hasn't existed before. So it would be something that's going to create its own interest for a start, I would say.
Well, this is fantastic. You always come up with absolutely terrific ideas. This is the best one yet, I think. I just love the idea that, we're all used to artists going global because the internet allows everyone access. But now they're going intergalactic. Now they're moving beyond the Earth. And who knows, maybe one day they will be on Mars. But I just want to congratulate you, as you're a pioneer of yourself. Now you're going to, to the moon itself. So I just want to congratulate you for that. Give us a comment below if you are amazed or if you have something to say about the artist going to the moon or being part of that historic event. Please check out Color in Your Life. I'm going to leave a link in the description of this video below as well. I want you to read about their moonshot, read about their show, and become part of their community. It's just an awesome and amazing artist community, and you've done a terrific job. I want to thank you, Graeme. Wish you the best with that. Please stay in touch and let us know what happens.